Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Build Riverwood. So there isn't actually that many comments about kind of what we need to do inside, which is good. It means that I think I've started to get the style with your guys' help as well, get the interiors done, get all the stuff generally done. I can kind of complete, this one was quite simple anyway, is a house. But what we're going to be doing today is, well, the sawmill. Obviously quite a big part of Riverwood. We've got the sawmill and we've got a small dock. So we'll kind of throw it onto here to kind of figure out stuff. Then, and I did ask you last episode as well if you wanted a time-lapse of the World Painter map, or if you just wanted me to talk you through it, and you guys went for time-lapse, which is totally cool by me. That will kind of quicken it up a bit. What I'll do is I'll do a time-lapse and I'll put some music to it. I don't think I'll actually talk over it. It's kind of difficult to talk through things. Especially when you're looking at it straight away. So that's what I'm going to do with that. Probably just put some music on it. Maybe do like I'll probably do a time lapse of the map in World Painter. Then I'll do a fly through. And what I'm planning on doing is putting in the road as well. I'm actually going to put that in first. There's going to be little touches up as well. Some of the rocks that kind of on the actual Skyrim map are quite kind of they're quite straight up. They're kind of like this. Well, not even like that. But you know, they're quite overhanging slightly with, so I'm going to have to put in those. I'll just do those kind of like hand painted. So that episode might take a little bit longer to get out because of that. Because I want to make it look really nice, like a little scene. And try and recreate it quite close. I don't want it to be exact because, that's pretty much impossible. But we've got lots of stuff. One of the other ones I get asked is what mods am I using? I am on Minecraft 1.7.2. What I did first is I installed Forge, then Optifine, Shaders, then I installed Camera Studio, and that's the reason I'm actually on 1.7, and my dog's going really loud in the background. But yeah, so I've got those three in Forge, so it's just Forge, Optifine, Shaders, Camera Studio. Then there's something called Light Loader. This is basically like a smaller modding type thing. It's kind of like Forge, but smaller. But that actually has a chain system, so as long as you've got Forge installed and you've got that working, you have to run Forge first, but the installation instructions are pretty easy. You can then run Light Loader, and it'll say, do you want to chain it to it, which basically means, do you want to connect it onto, and then in your client you'll get Forge plus Light Loader, and then you need World Edit Wrapper, World Edit Wrapper, and also the one that I use for the actual visual box type thing. Is World Edit CUI, and that's all I've got. If you guys do really need a tutorial, I'll do one, though I'll have to kind of I just don't want to mess up my own version of Minecraft, if that makes sense, because I literally install mods when I have to, and that's about it, you know. So it's not something that's my specialty, but if you guys really really want it, you know, make sure you tell me. But what we're gonna do now is jump into Skyrim, have a look at these two places. They're going to be really easy. I'm pretty sure that the pier has just got like this style, so because we've already established it, it's going to be super duper easy. So it should be a quick episode. Okay, so we're back into Skyrim. Lovely Skyrim. And it's foggy, which is weird. I think this is probably one of the mods that I've got. It's not normally foggy, is it? No, I'm sure it must be a mod. I don't know, I installed loads of mods. It's just like a group of really good graphical ones, but let's have a look at this, which is the sawmill, or the water-powered sawmill. I've kind of already made, well, I've made a water-powered sawmill already in Dakr, and it was mainly based off this, but it wasn't kind of exact, whereas we're going to go for a kind of exact one, including these posts that go up and do all of that stuff. So if we have a look here, these sections are sections of three again. So that side part is going to be really easy. It's just like a three and a one. We do have a ramp. Kind of quite a big ramp. So we'll see, we'll kind of see. What I'm going to do is, instead of trying to count it and make it exact, I'll just see what the curve does with that. Well, not curve, but diagonal line thing. Stored wood up here. I really want, hopefully Monster gets some, like, rope. Well, it has to be iron bars. Rope iron bars would be awesome type thing. That would be cool. So we got this thing. Now this is quite big, actually. I'm looking at this section that we've used. It's like two of them. Okay. That is really big. That's like, that'd be seven. Yeah, because if we have a look at that's definitely like a free section like we've got here. So 7. Ooh, that's quite cool. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 going that way. We've got the 3 on the side. And then obviously this thing's going to be a nightmare. I have no idea how I'm going to do it. Oh, we can do this one, I think, in Minecraft. Do you know how... Do you think we can do that, guys? Yeah, we've got one of those. We've got a lever. So this part is one back there. But I'm not going to be super exact with it, but this part just goes off the side. That's cool. This pier, there's sections of three. What I'm going to do with this pier is I'm not going to make it the exact same. It looks... It is basically the top of that wall, isn't it? So the pier, what I'm actually going to do... I don't think you guys nearly need to see me build that. The roof as well is the same as the one that we've got over here. And you can kind of see that this is just a bigger circle. So this pier, because it really... I mean, honestly, is just that taken off there. I'll build this one quickly off camera. I'll show you guys what I've done and to change the kind of wall bit. But basically, it'll just be where you had the cobblestone underneath. Just taking that out. There really doesn't seem anything to it. So that one will be quick. This one will also be pretty quick as well, I think. So let's jump back in. Oh, actually, wait. Before we do that, I need to find out. So it's in the middle of that section. Kind of in the middle. I mean, this droops down quite a bit. Oh, was I getting pushed by water? Oh, you do. Was that always there as well? I can't remember. But anyway, we're going to jump in and build this thing. Okay, so here is what I've got for the pier. Pretty simple. What I've basically done is copied that section that we've got here. Instead of putting the cobblestone down underneath, just having the kind of pillars go down into the water, as you can see here. And actually, weird. Normally with shaders you can't really see underwater, but I don't know, maybe Zeus has made some... Well, Sonic Aether has made some kind of additions. But yeah, just kept that style going through. Pretty standard. And not really too much to it, just got that end section. But it is the wall. I mean, it really is. Every single little bit of it is pretty much the same, which is quite cool. And it works. It's quite a nice little pier, actually. So I might... I don't know. If I do Riverwood differently or not. Might put a couple of these, maybe, and put like a little boat or something. Or I might just keep... No, I'll just keep it normal. I think otherwise people that download it will be saying stuff. But yeah. Right, so we're going to build the, what's it called? Sawmill. There we go. I got it. So this is where the wood's going to come off. So we're just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, okay. And 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that'll go across by 2. Like this, 1, 2, 3. And then complete this. It's quite big actually, isn't it? I didn't really realise. Oh, I've gone off somewhere. There we go, that's where I've gone. It is actually a pretty big building. And so there we go, that's that. So if we have the wood fall off this part, the ramp on the other side, which means the side bit will be here. That's only comes out by 3, so you got just this. Okay, it's gone wrong somewhere. How have I gone so wrong? Okay. How did I join it up correctly as well? Oh dear. Oh dear indeed. Right, so we've got 1, 2. Oh, there we go. Okay, that's good. So there. There we have it. So we're just going to have 3 of these sections. Like that. So this is the little extension where you got the wood sitting on it. This is where we're going to have the ramp going down. The ramp's pretty big, actually. I'm going to do it across like this for the time being. And then come down. I think what I'll do is, kind of like what I did with the wall over here, I kind of bordered it. I think I'll do something like that, but I'm going to obviously make it a lot more sloped downwards. But I'll have the logs inside, so I'll kind of change it. But it doesn't really matter because it makes it better, so... Or makes it look better, at least. Even if it's not super duper accurate, but that's kind of what you gotta do. So we've got this. Let's go down to here. And we've got one more. Or kind of a couple more. I think this will work a lot better than trying to do it either with stairs or just normally. So, go there. Go there. There. It's a bit weird with the. Oh well, it doesn't matter. A bit weird with the stuff. Yes, with the stuff indeed. Okay, so then we can figure out where we can get these to be even. And have like a pole. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that's good. We'll do something like that. Those two end ones, that'll do as a supports. So we've just got one block gap on each of those. I think I did that the same on the other side. Yes, I did. Okay. What we're going to do now, if we just put down these. Now, this part didn't have a roof. And this bit just... I didn't actually check to see if there was solid... I think it was just solid stone going across that one, but that's fine. Also, this can come out as well. That we don't need. And I can't remember either what was underneath. I don't think you could see it. It's the tiny little details that you completely forget about, but I'm going to block it up for the time being. Maybe that'll look better. I don't know. We will see. I'll do that. And then just going on the inside as well on all of these. And I really should have built this next to the water. I'm actually realizing that now. But what I might do in a second is I might move it over. It's going to be quite difficult to get it right next to the water to fit. At least down here, it's kind of on a weird slope. I think actually, no, I'll have to build it here because when I copy into the world anyway, I have to edit stuff. Whereas if I do it here, there's so much slopey ground. It'll be a little bit weird, but I might just cut into the ground here or whatever. I think, I mean, the wheel's going to be like here anyway. And that would be longer. Because this bit will be in the water. Is the ramp that big? Yeah. Yeah. Alright. That's fine. Pretty sure it is. So, build up all of these walls. I will get back to you after I've done that. Okay, so there we go. I have filled in all of the back walls. I've also put in the upside down stairs. And I decided, why not while I'm at it, get the boring task of actually getting all of this flooring done. So now I'm just going to put some of these fences across because, well, we don't have anything else at the minute. That end one we'll leave completely clear. Now, with this one, with the one that I did in my, on Dakadale, I had it cut into the ground. This one's actually kind of raised up. Or at least it looks like it is. So that's going to be interesting as well. What we'll do first. So we're going to just go up on these. Oh, I didn't think about that, did I? Pretty sure, though. 2, 3. I think it actually does do this, doesn't it? No, it can't do. Otherwise, how do the logs get through? No, that has to be like that. I'll have to jump in at some point, I think. We'll get most of it done. Just I'm wondering how it's supported on this side without, you know, being supported. This 7 might be too big, even though it's kind of what it looks like. It looks a little bit too wide. Yeah, it definitely does, doesn't it? What I'm going to do is I'm going to just quickly weld edit this over. Okay, so MC edited it over in the end. It just gets quicker. But, yep, so I've done this as a 5 now. And I think proportion-wise, that looks a little bit better. It just looked too wide. It's really weird. There we go, so I'm going to put one of these on top here. And I'll just do this side. But basically, the roof style was actually the same as that one and... Whoop, there we go, the pier. Like that. So we're going to be doing those ones. That's a really weird way of building, actually. I'm not sure if I'll keep on doing these for the sawmill, because it's not as... Because it's kind of wide enough, it doesn't really need it. Still, now for the time being, and what I'll do in a bit, I'll grab the upside down variant versions. But we can do this. Like that. And then this one, obviously, will go down as well. I can just go across with this 3. That's basically just going to be a bigger version. It'd be interesting how to do the archy bit. That bit. Which we did with the slabs before. That will be interesting. Okay, three. There, and connect those across. I think you guys know what I mean by where the supports are, hopefully. But it shouldn't be a problem. Okay. So now we have this. Do is I'm going to grab this clay, put this one in, this kind of roofing tiles, leaving off the middle ones, and you can see that on the edges I just got to four, so I go all the way over to these because we've got the overhang. So that's what I'm going to do on these. Fill this up, and what I'll do is I'll show you what on one side, and then I'll just obviously copy and paste it onto the other off camera. So let me have like that. Okay, across the top, we're gonna have this one. And that actually goes over like that, I think. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Because then you have that and that. Yeah. Okay, and then down here. That and upside down stairs there, and then this is going to be quite easy if we get them the right way around. So you're just using the spruce wood instead, because it's a bit darker, keeps with the same style that we did on the wall, and also the other thing. I don't know, I didn't fall through a random stair down somewhere. Okay, so we have this. Oh, I did throw a random stair down somewhere, I don't know how I got it there, but okay. That gives us that half. What I'm going to do now is I'll copy this to the other side, and then we can figure out that archy bit. Okay, so I've completed the roof on the other side as well. Got those overhangs. I also put in the fence on these parts because I completely forgot about that. And then the final bit is just putting in on the roof, actually putting in these kind of, what they call the stairs. It just makes it a bit smoother, and also putting in those kind of stair variations that we have from these, you know, like the wood, the log ones, and it looks like the texture is actually fixed on them. So I don't know, maybe I've got the latest version of Conquest, so I'm guessing there was some sort of glitchy type thing, but that will give us this little area. I'm glad I went for a 5 instead of a 7. I think this actually feels a little bit more like it. So actually counting the sections didn't work quite well. That's fine. It's probably because of it being 3 and then it's got this big 1 thing instead of just like a pole being pretty small. Yeah, so right, well, what are we going to do now? This little section here is where we've got the cutty thing. And, got some of these going up, maybe? And I know that it goes up into the roofy part, so put in those for now. And I think we're going to have to use those like that, and then something. I don't know, actually, this is going to be difficult. Iron bars wise, can we do something with the iron bars? I get like a saw. Maybe? Kind of want it to go like this way, don't we? Can we do that? Yeah, we can do something like this. And I think this. I don't really know which iron bars to use. I don't know. Yeah, that's quite interesting. I think we have to go this way as well. Now, to build this like trough type thing, I think what we'll have to do. I think I'm gonna have to jump into Skyrim, have a look. Obviously, we can just fill this up with wood. What we need to find out is what's happening on these poles. I don't think they go down. It's just kind of like a floating roof, which is fine. And mainly have a look at this little section here and these little bits. Down here, I think it's gonna be quite easy. Just like a 1, 2, 3. Do something like that, 1, 2, 3. Try like that, I don't know. Make a couple of posts. That's like this, and then obviously with my log, put down these like so. Let them overhang a bit. Oh, yeah, make that much shorter, why not? Okay. Yeah, you can kind of see what I'm doing on this part, just making random logs. Probably also grabbing. Where's spruce? That's spruce. Why is that weird? Spruce might work as well in here. Maybe it'll work better. Yeah, I think spruce will work better. So I'm going to switch those out. I'll do them all the same length at the same at the time. At the current time. Oh, a minute. Right. Switch these out, and then if we build upwards as well. couple. Now I've got to do it on the other side as well. Make it even, why not? Or odd even. Odd even? Yes. Okay. So there. So we've got this kind of like very strict pile which looks not great. You can tell that it doesn't look great. So I'm just gonna go like this, cut off a couple of these. And do the same on here. Don't want to do that too much. It's a little bit too much there. And okay, cut off, keep that one, but cut off this one, cut off that one, lengthen that one, lengthen that one so it's sticking out a little bit. That actually looks quite cool. So I might do the same on here and sticking out one. Pile of wood. Excellent. Put that in there. Yeah, good enough. That's good enough. So we've got the little posts. We've got some wood that's been cut. We just need to figure out exactly how this works here. So we'll jump into Skyrim. Okay, so here we are in Skyrim again. I do definitely think that actually that vibe definitely worked. I completely forgot about these bits. That's not good. Yeah, I'll do the curvy bits as well. But this, okay, so it's made out of wood. That's one of the things I needed to know. Made out of wood. I can kind of see where I got this part from, this journey bit, and I think those are all right, actually. Did they line up with this? The wheel doesn't line up. How does that work, then? Okay, so this is in line with that beam, then, if you want to be exact. And yeah, I think that's going to be the closest we can do. This is just like a little trough-type thing. That's actually pretty easy. And yeah, no beamy bits. That's easy. Okay. That's cool. That's good. I mean, there's all this other objects and stuff, but I'll do that when I actually put the whole thing together. And also, obviously, these little bridges, they're not really bridges. The only other bridge I want to get in is this one. But that'll have to do, you have to do a river. Bridges you can't really pre-build and shove in. When you can, you can't. Well, I mean, you can, but you know what I mean. This part actually works quite well, as you can see with the posts here. There is, just noticed, this little extension part. Didn't know about that. And this wall comes out. Okay. It's a little detail I didn't notice. I wonder what's on the other side as well. We could also do the rope tying. Yeah, I'm going to do the rope tying ones. Yeah, there we go. So it's just cobblestone underneath. But I'm happy with the one I got, so that's okay. I think we pretty much got it. We need to do some sort of... Well, we don't need to, but I'd like to do some sort of... Oh, balls. Yeah, that's good. No, go away. Anyway, I'll jump in after I've just cancelled out of this. Alright, so the first thing we need to do is the... bit. That bit. You know what I mean. So, if we go to here, maybe. Can we just do like an elongated version of it? Let's try it first. No, we don't. We need it to be a bit closer, so we need stairs as well. That's alright. That's not too bad. No idea how this is going to work out. But if we have like stairs here, then a slab. Oh, not that. There's a slab. And then... just a slab? Does that look okay? Or do we then also do so? No, we don't do that. That's weird. Okay. Do this. I mean, we could obviously go across. That just looks boring, though, doesn't it? Or do something like that. And that also looks pretty boring. Okay, I think the only real way we can do it is do it like that. That's fine by me. So I'm just going to go over there. We'll move this over in a bit. Or now, actually. Let's cut it out. I was going to try and find a nicer... not really nicer, a different version for the other thing as well. So we've got this going up, and we'll just do that here a bit. There we go. Oh yeah, we'll interfere with this part. There we go, that's why I put that in. Clever. Well, not really, but you know what I mean. So, well, that worked out quite nicely. We've got on here, there, click on that, there, fly around. What I might do is do this. No, I won't even put one in there. It looks a bit weird, doesn't it? There. Good. At least we got something there. No, I'm not too sure about the stairs. Yeah, I'm not gonna go over the stairs. Say go changing my mind. No, I just went over. I think it's just gotta be quite simple. It doesn't have to be really elaborate. Yeah, maybe that works a little bit better. It kind of offsets the this as well. It's quite a nice little design thing. Quite cool. Okay, so we're just gonna go over up there. Up one more. All down. So we can fit in two of those, right? So if we just grab first some sort of probably oak wood will do. Put in these. Pretty much went all the way to here, but I'm just gonna do it one short. And this had an extension on it. And it was like a weird extension. Which really only held this. I have to knock back some of this wood around here, and this part was supposed to have come out as well. What I might do is just do it behind here. That's all of that. Maybe. Grab a stone. Yeah, I'll do something like this. Just adds a little bit of variation, but doesn't really do anything. I actually hate that. So I'm really not going to do that. I'm actually going to keep it how it was. That's what I'll do. I'll just have it like it's just an extension. I think it looks better. Yeah, just do something like that. And then these will then continue on. I might do it one short, or go all the way. And put in a thingamajig there. I'll go to this. Okay, that's good. I think possibly as well, just to make it a little bit different, put in some oak wood slabs on this, it'll join it up as well. That'll give me a full block in there. Just got the normal one, I don't know how Conquest works with the double. Yeah, so. Still connects in, okay, that doesn't matter. Well, we'll do that anyway. Okay, now if I fly over here. And. Does that look too big? Kinda, but I don't know. Maybe that does look better. All we have to do is do this instead. Yeah, I think that's gonna be the way to do it. Put it down. Come on, there we go. That'll do. Yeah, that looks better. That's good. This part, we do have, obviously, we have the sorry part here. We have the lever. So put that in roughly there. Doesn't really matter. There or there. Meh, it's fine. Iron bars. Now what we'll do is we'll go all the way across this part. That. So we've got iron bars going across there. It's a shame they connect into those parts, so maybe do this just to get it to look a little bit better. And it doesn't really look like it's unsupported there, so that's fine. So we've got that there. Pretty cool. Maybe you're gonna have those two. I think three of them is a bit overkill, and maybe yeah, just do the forward two, I think. Or even just doing that would be fine. I think actually, yeah, just doing this, the reason being that you can see it from more angles, so that's fine. We will grab some more wood as well. I need to lengthen some of these now. I look a little bit short. The wood here was like pretty nuts actually. It's kind of everywhere, but that'll do. So we've got that bit. Obviously this, that's okay. Wheel type thing here. Don't really know what to do for that bit. Or if we need to do anything for it. I'll leave that bit for the time being. We'll make a nice log pile here though. So I'll just do like a nice little one right here. This one up a little bit higher maybe. This one down here. And one more, something a bit higher. I'll push it right against. I might push it right against. I'll just have some more random wood here or something. There you go, that looks quite cool. Get a wood pile, you then grab the logs, put them onto this. Somehow they get moved by magic. Crossed it here, where they get cut. Cool. And because of that. Now I reckon I'm going to use oak wood for oak wood stairs or whatever. I'm going to use that. I'll need a couple more of these as well. Might need the slabs as well. There we go. So it was on this section, right in the middle. I'll go out a couple. Now, how big are we going to make this thing? I think here. So I'm going to need to cut into the ground a bit. That's fine. Three, type one here. It stays like this. And maybe we can't do that on sides. Aha. But we can do this. We're going to make a smaller one. There. And this will be obviously upside downstairs. I'm just going to cut out more of this. I'll copy it after, remember about this part. So I'll just get rid of all of this stuff. There we go. Get rid of it all. This might actually make it look a little bit better as well. It's quite good. So there we go. Put that in. Put those in. Cut this back. And. Right. We have this wheel. Go upside down here. Do something like this. Oh. Alright, I got it. I am going wrong. Try and imagine weird circular things. Do that. And we have a circle. That actually fits really nicely. And it's easy. I think it's the same one that I used in the Dakadale one, actually, but if it works, and why not, right? Why did it connect in weird like that? It's really odd. Something up here. Don't know. Not going to question it. Okay, so we've got this. Shove a button on the end. Why not? I think it doesn't need to stick out as much. Yeah, that looks cool. I like that. Possibly switch that out actually for spruce wood. If I do, yeah, I think that needs to be spruce wood. What I'm going to do now, I'll literally just switch that out for spruce wood. I'm also going to grab the rope texture type thing. We can have another final look at it, and then that'll probably be it. Okay, so this is what we've got. So I think this spruce wood does work a lot better. It makes it look a lot more kind of worn. I actually ended up switching this out for a spruce wood log as well, just to give it a bit of a more kind of close to the water, kind of not, you know, I don't know what type of look I'm going for. Close to the water look. So the only other thing I've done is just switched out these, and that's pretty much it. Not too much else. Added in an extra log just in here. It's going to look like it's been active, but that is pretty much it. So we've got the time lapse next episode. And a nice little fly through, and then I'm kind of thinking about doing. I'm not really too sure what I'm going to do when we're putting it all together. If you guys want me to do it MC edit wise, do you want me to plop it in, or do you want me to kind of do a tour? I don't know. Depends if you're getting bored of this season, series, or whatever it is. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you on the next one.